Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning my students. Today we will continue to study our natural resource part 2. Last week we have discussed that we can get natural resource from the environment. And then we have discussed too the factor that made the environment. There are biotic and abiotic factor. And then we also have discussed about some examples of natural resource: air, water, and also soil or land. For today, we will continue to discuss another natural resource: plants and animal, and also fuel. Plant and animal. We can get food from the plant and animal, and then we also can get some materials from the plant and animal. Here are the example. You can open your book, page 50. About the plants and animal. Okay, look at the picture here. The chicken give us meat and egg, and then the cow give us milk, which can be used to make cheese. These are the example that we can get food from some animals. And then the next picture, wool can be used to make coat, hat, and scarf. This is the example that we can get some material from the animals, from the wool, dari bulu domba. The next picture, okay, you can see this is the frame of this house is made up of wood. The frame of this house is made of wood. So this is the example that we can get material from the plant. We can get wood from the plant to make the frame of the house. And then this floor and this cupboard are made of wood. So this is the example that we can get material from the plant. So this is similar, yeah? The frame of this house and then the cupboard are made of wood. These are the examples that the plant and animal can give us food and also material. The next natural resource that we will discuss are fuels in bahasa bahan bakar. Fuels are burned to produce heat and generate electricity. So it has general function, two general function. Fungsi umumnya apa? To produce heat and generate electricity. Menghasilkan panas dan pembangkit listrik, membangkitkan tenaga listrik. Okay, here are the examples of fuels: coal, oil, natural gas, and also wood. Coal, it's mean batu bara. Oil, here it's mean minyak bumi, and then gas alam, natural gas, and then wood. For coal, oil, and natural gas, they are include in fossil fuel. Jadi tiga ini, coal, batu bara, oil, minyak bumi, dan gas alam, natural gas, they are include in fossil fuel, termasuk bahan bakar fosil. How about wood? Wood is not fossil fuel. It's come from the plant. Nah, what is fossil fuel, teacher? Apa sih bahan bakar fosil itu? Let's see the definitions. Fossil fuels form from dead organism is the fuel that form from dead organism. Jadi, keywordnya satu. It form from dead organism. Terbentuknya dari makhluk hidup yang sudah mati, that were buried, terpendam, terkubur under layer of earth million years ago, dalam jangka waktu yang lama, jadi jutaan tahun yang lalu. So fossil fuels are the fuels that form from dead organism that were buried under layer of earth million years ago. So coal, oil, and natural gas, they are come from dead organism. Jadi batu bara, minyak bumi, dan gas alam, it come from dead organism that buried, yang terkubur under layer of the earth million years ago. Look at the picture here. The picture shows about the oil and natural gas formations. About oil and natural gas formation, and then about how coal was formed. So we know from the definition that oil, coal, and natural gas, it come from dead organism. Ya, jadi dari organisme. That Look at that teacher circle. The dead and buried under layer of the earth. Jadi dia terpendam. Okay. After million years, and then it is taken, diambil for oil and natural gas. You can see this is the drills. Jadi diambil, dibor until thousands kilometer to get the oils, because after the organism, the dead organism buried under layer of the earth, it get pressures, mendapat tekanan from the earth, it got heat, it got friction, dapat gesekan until it produce oil. The oil will be taken by drilling, dengan cara dibor. After that, what will we get, teacher? We will get the crude oil, yang didapat minyak mentah. For the coal, it almost same, but for the coal, we will mine it. Jadi ditambang. Kalau coal, batu bara itu ditambang, but for the oil and natural gas, we'll drill it. Jadi dibor. After that, what happen? After we take the oil by drilling, the oil is processed in oil refineries. Jadi diproses dulu. You get the crude oil, yang didapat minyak mentah. After that, it is processed in oil refineries. Pemurnian minyak bumi ya. And then you will get petrol. After that, you will get diesel. And then you will get kerosene, etc. So the petrol, diesels, kerosene that you see, they are the product of the oil. Jadi bensin, solar, diesel, sand, dan kerosene, minyak tanah that you see, yang kita sudah lihat itu, this, they are the product of oil. The oil that have processed, the oil that has processed in oil refineries. So don't imagine after drilling. Jadi jangan dibayangkan after drilling, setelah proses pengeboran, you got the gasoline, you got the kerosene, you got the diesel directly. Jadi langsung dapat bensin, langsung dapat solar, langsung dapat minyak tanah. No, but you got the crude oil. Jadi yang didapat itu crude oil, minyak mentah. That the color black, that the odor is so smell, bau, berbau, dia warnanya juga hitam ya. So after that it process in oil refineries. After from the oil refineries, baru you got the gasoline that you see. Jadi yang kita lihat bensin itu adalah product from the oil that has processed. Jadi itu semuanya sudah diproses, the crude oil that has process. So you got the petrol, got the diesel, and then also got the kerosene. They are the product of the oil that has process, yang sudah diproses. And then now let's see the functions of fuels. Okay, we have finished discuss about fossil fuels. Now let's see the functions of fuels. So fuels in general. Okay, the first two used to power of some cars. Okay, for vehicles, yeah, the petrol is used to power of some cars, and then the stove. Okay, the stove heat up food using natural gas. So natural gas for cooking, and then petrol for vehicle. Jadi natural gas, and then we can see to the wood. Wood, it is to cook food also, and then another, okay, and then coal to generate electricity. This is the functions of fuel. Jadi ada yang for cooking, for example wood and natural gas, and then for vehicle, petrol, and then diesel, and then how about coal? Coal for generating electricity, for generating electricity sebagai pembangkit listrik. This is the functions of fuels. Then some natural resource, renewable. Renewable, it's been, will never run out, will always be renew, akan selalu ada, tidak akan habis. For example, the air, water, and then soil, they will not run out. But other non-renewable, tapi ada yang tidak bisa diperbarui, such as fossil fuels that we have discussed, coal, oil, natural gas, they are non-renewable. So, that non-renewable, this is that will run out one day. So, we have to do something to conserve that. Jadi, kita harus melakukan sesuatu untuk mengkonserve, melestarikan the non-renewable resource. Teacher, how about renewable resource? Apa tidak perlu dilestarikan? Apa cuma non-renewable aja, teacher, yang dilestarikan? No, we have to be balanced. Tetap harus seimbang. We have to conserve all the natural resource. But you have to be careful for non-renewable. Harus berhati-hati untuk non-renewable ini. Kenapa? Because they will run out one day. So we have to find the ways. Harus menemukan cara to conserve it. Untuk melestarikan non-renewable resource. How can we conserve our natural resource? Let's see here. The first way, by reduce, reuse, recycle. Reduce, mengurangi, reuse, menggunakan lagi, and recycle, daur ulang. We can see the examples here. Okay. Reduce, ya, mengurangi. So, we can reduce our use of water by turning the water tap off properly, ya. Mematikan keran air kalau tidak dipakai. This is the examples of reduce. And then we can reuse too. Bisa menggunakan lagi. For example, the plastic bottle. We can use it as a plant pot to grow the plant. Yeah? So this is the examples of reuse. How about recycle? The examples of recycle. The steel can be recycled. Jadi baja itu bisa didaur ulang to make some types of pipe. And then we can also recycle different types of thing by using the correct bin, ya. Jadi kita bisa recycle benda itu dengan menggunakan separate bin, rubbish bin yang terpisah. We can put paper in other bin, and then plastic in other bin, and then metal in other bin. So if we want to recycle, we can take it easier. Lebih mudah ngambilnya. Kita mau buat sesuatu dari sampah logam. So we take from the bin that come from metal. We want to make something from the paper. So we can take the bin from the paper bin. So this is help you to recycle the separate bin. Tempat sampah yang terpisah. And then the next way to conserve our natural resource is using less fossil fuel, menggunakan bahan bakar fosil lebih sedikit. So, reduce the use of fossil fuel, mengurangi penggunaan bahan bakar fosil. We know that the fossil fuels are non-renewable resource. Tidak bisa diperbarui. Fossil fuel itu are non-renewable resource. Why, teacher? Because we have studied the process. They need a long time to process. Mereka butuh long time, million years. Jadi perlu jutaan tahun untuk proses. So they will be run out one day. Jadi dikhawatirkan habis suatu saat. So we have to reduce the use of fossil fuel. How, teacher? Bagaimana caranya reduce the use of fossil fuel? First, we can walk, jalan kaki in near distance. We can cycle, bersepeda in near distance. So it's better than you use motor cycle. Motor cycle itu use fossil fuel. They use gasoline. Mereka pakai bensin. So it's better to you for walking or cycling in near distance than you use motor vehicle. Other ways, cara yang lain, for example, use public transportation. Gunakan kendaraan umum, it's better than you use the private vehicle. Kalau vehicle-nya private, for example, you want to go to Surabaya, and then your friend want to go to Surabaya, they use motor private car. Semuanya pakai mobil pribadi, isinya cuma satu orang, jadi one car, one person. It's better if you use public transportation. One public transportation, satu transportasi umum bisa berapa orang. So they go to Surabaya together. This is mean you use less fossil fuel. Berarti kita sudah menggunakan lebih sedikit fossil fuel. We reduce the use of fossil fuels. And then the last way to conserve natural resource, stop the illegal cutting down of trees. Stop cutting down of trees. Berhenti menebang pohon. Ya, It's better for us to do reforestation. Malah kita itu harus reforestation, menanam lagi. Trees need time to grow. We should plant them and continue to care of them. We know that trees produce the fresh air. It will keep the soil. Jadi banyak kegunaannya. So you have to stop illegal cutting down. Berhenti menebang pohon secara ilegal. This is the last way to conserve the natural resource. Okay, my student, we have finished with the topic of our natural resource. Now you can do your task in your book and then you can submit it on Saturday. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.